Her first U.S. single, It's a Heartache, hit number 3. But it was a throat ache that created Bonnie's signature sound after doctors removed nodules from her vocal cords back in 1976. In 1983, she hooked up with Jim Steinman, the man who brought melodrama to Meatloaf. She recorded her biggest and longest hit, the 7-minute total Eclipse of the Heart.
I remember just thinking, this is too good. You know, this song is just too good for the radio. I just thought it was so majestic and so big that no radio station were going to play it. And then it got picked up and picked up, and then it just went enormous.
The epic stayed at number 1 for 4 weeks, and Bonnie was nominated for a Grammy. The following year, Bonnie teamed up with Steinman again for Holding Out for a Hero from the film Footloose. The soundtrack went triple platinum. It was Kevin Bacon's Finest Hour.
In the film, where Kevin Bacon is on the tractor, you know, and he's got his shoelaces caught around the pedal, and he can't get off this tractor, and the other boy that's going towards him, you know, realizes that he's not going to get off there. The other guy falls off, and so Kevin Bacon's the hero.
Then the hit stopped. 2 more Steinman collaborations went nowhere, and Bonnie headed back to the UK. So where is Bonnie Tyler now?
They call me mean. People call me evil.
Still a rock star, this time in Europe.
There's so many nationalities in here tonight. And I probably don't speak any of your languages. Believe it or not, even though I'm not in the charts, and I haven't been in the charts for a very long time, I am so busy. I sometimes wonder, are these kids in the charts as busy as I am?
Tired tracks and broken heart. Let's get away from the past.
In 1998, she performed in Andrew Lloyd Webber's Whistle Down the Wind, co-written by her old pal, Jim Steinman. In 1999, she recorded a song for composer and former Yes keyboardist Rick Wakeman.
I spoke to Bonnie about it 4 years ago. Such a great voice. And I said, you know, I'd love to write a song for you for this project. She said, well, it'd be nice, you know.
Rick Wakeman's A Return to the Center of the Earth is a musical sequel to the 1974 Journey to the Center of the Earth, and is hosted by Patrick Stewart. Although she and her real estate mogul hubby own more than 20 homes, Bonnie makes her permanent digs on the coast of her native Wales.
Bye-bye. I commute from Wales because my family are here. I'm very, very close to my family, so I don't like to be too far away from them. But I still love Wales.
Bonnie's even found time to perform in a high-profile concert for the Welsh Assembly.
And I really love doing live shows, you know, with my band. That's where my love is, and that's where the real Bonnie Tyler comes out, you know?
Life's been good to me.
Bonnie, the rock star, continues to win awards, including a 1999 Lifetime Achievement Award for Best International Female Rock Singer. The awards come in handy around the Tyler estate.
Great for keeping doors open in the summer, you know, when you got all your doors open. I got one over there, one out there, one in there. I mean, you may as well use them, yes.
Though she still sings about holding out and heartaches, Bonnie's future recordings are on a more positive note.